Hi, welcome to Free Spirit and welcome to another close-up review. So this is a new release that came out about a month ago. I've been meaning to do this close-up review as well. It's divine timing. We've been talking a lot about the higher self. This is all to help you align more to your higher self. It's the Soul Helper Oracle Messages from Your Higher Self from Christine Arana. I hope I'm pronouncing her name correctly, illustrated by Elena Dudina. Hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. Soul Helper Oracle Messages from Your Higher Self. So there are going to be 43 cards in here. We're going to go into all the cards. At the end, we'll do a bonus reading. I just took the cover off, the plastic off. I did not even look at the cards whatsoever. This is the guidebook that it will come with. It will be black and white pictures lost in the ruins of the past. Wow, wow, wow. Wow, it gives you the power animal, moose, lemon. I'm addicted to lemons, by the way. And the number associated, 9. Lost in the past, in the ruins of the past, find the way to be in the present moment and live. Okay, they literally had me post that spirit message tip, which barely nobody read or watched, but it was literally how to tune into love, start your day with love and go from there and to be present in the moment. So we just got that. So, because we're probably living a lot in the past in our minds. A wonderful surprise is coming has been a recurring message. Something entirely new awaits you. And here, I love this. It will all give a full meaning of the card, but the power animal, herbal essence, oil, vanilla, healing crystal, and the number. I love that it's broken out like that. You are experiencing a spiritual blossoming. Take a new direction and be open to new experiences. Power animal, the owl, herbal essence, oil, peppermint, healing crystal, clear quartz, number 4. I love it. These are like recurring messages, by the way. But at the end, we'll do a bonus reading, but let's get into the cards. 43 cards, I believe. Yep, messages from your higher soul, soul, helper, oracle. Love it already. It had me at the title, like it had me at hello. These are the backs of the cards, beautiful. I love the peacock image. And it looks like it's like good for all ages. You know, whenever I see artwork like this, it's like good for even, you know, younger people. I love the colors and the images in here. It's one of the reasons why I bought the deck. I even love this on the sides of it. I found it so pretty and it's very colorful and I just loved it. And I love the tone of the messages. So let's get into it. So re-energize in the natural world. Let your inner hunter or huntress take rest. I love it. Re-energize in the natural world. Yes, follow the path of your soul. Do not allow anyone or anything to stop you. I love that. That spoke to me too when I saw it. Awaken the magic of your creativity. Immerse yourself in the world of feelings. Awaken all your senses. Slow down and become aware of them. Beautiful messages. It's time for a change. Do not wait or put off decisions any longer. Love that butterfly. I love, oh, it's so pretty. I see what I mean. Like, it's good images for even younger. Your deepest desires constrain you. Let them go to clear your mind. Release your creative energies. Make use of them in your life. Live in this world as a dreamer. Create a future paradise. Yes. That's what we're being urged to do right now, despite what's going on in the world. Leave your usual social circles behind. Seek out true companions. Yes, love that. Feel the power of your blood and your ancestors. You are not alone. Love that. The time is right. Seize the day and make progress on your soul path. A new strategy is required. Find the path to love and happiness. Beautiful. Rise above the dark days of life. Do not fight them, but have faith that the light will always return. I love that message. I always got the message, don't fight the dark. You just bring in more light. Absolutely. Bring in more light. Rise above the dark days of your life. A difficult path is being revealed. A difficult path is being revealed. Ask for help and learn that we are all connected. You cast a spell with your existence. Magic flows brightly and radiantly within you. Beautiful. To conform is to die inside. Be brave and be yourself. Yeah, it is. To conform is to die inside. Flames of desire, let them shine out in radiant light and shun dark paths. lost in the ruins of the past, find the way to the present moment and live. Enter the temple of your truth and learn to value it. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Nature is calling you. It wants to touch, fulfill, and protect you with its healing powers. So true. Recognize despair as an opportunity. Within it, you will find the gift of awakening. Recognize despair as an opportunity. The time for romance has come. See it as an opportunity for a radiant life. Release your inner rebel. Be yourself and create your own universe. Love that. The tree of wishes is calling your name. An almost forgotten wish will now come true. Protect what you love. It is your duty and responsibility. The love of your dragon reaches out to you. The realm of your truth is opening up. A wonderful surprise is coming. Something entirely new awaits you. Have the courage to be free. Know that freedom begins where desire ends. Live playfully and with a light heart. Listen to the voice of your inner child. Live playfully and with a light heart. I was always getting live lightheartedly. It's like the secret to everything. Live lightheartedly. Anyway, it's just reminding me of that. Live playfully and with a light heart. Listen to the voice of your inner child. A partnership for the new age. It is time to welcome it. Beautiful. You are experiencing a spiritual blossoming. Take a new direction and be open to new experiences. Tear down the walls around your heart. Give and receive security and warmth. Listen to the eternal song of your soul. Tune into it and learn to trust it. You heard the honk? And that's number 33, which I always pay attention to. Yeah. Learn to trust it. Tune into it and trust it. 33. Beautiful. You are unique. Be brave, a little crazy, but be yourself. Yep. Totally true. Follow your vision. Never lose sight of what is really important. That's on the cover. Success and happiness are coming. Enjoy and celebrate life. A message is trying to reach you. Be vigilant. The spirit world wishes to find and touch you. A light-filled angel is at your side. It watches over you in every dark doorway. The time of guilt and shame ends now. Forgive yourself and begin to love yourself just as you are. You are caught up in drama. Ask to free yourself. Act to free yourself. Change and blossom again. You're caught up in the drama. The lotus within you awakens. You are a master in light on high. Oh, I love that. I love that sentence. You are a master in light on high. Yes, the lotus within you awakens. Cross the bridge of happiness. It leads over the depths of your emotions. Yeah, beautiful. Have courage. Awaken the warrior of light within you. Beautiful. So these were 43 cards. Let's do a bonus reading at the end, but these are the backs of the cards. Beautiful soul helper oracle. So let's tap in and do a bonus reading for all who may find this video right now. Hot messages from your higher self. What's to come through for all of us at this time? Let's see. Beautiful deck. Soul helper oracle. What are the messages that want to come through for us right now, for anyone who may find this video? With everything that's going on in the big stage, small stage. Oh, wow. They're ready already. Okay. Messages from soul helper oracle. Beautiful deck. I think it came out like a month ago. It's been sitting to the side. I just didn't have time to do a close-up review. It had me at the title. Yes, I knew this was going to come out. I kind of paused on this card. A wonderful surprise is coming. By the way, every time I do a reading on the channel, we've been saying surprise, surprise, surprise. Wonderful surprise is coming. Something entirely new awaits you. So there's going to be things coming in that will surprise you that are new. Wonderful new things are coming in. Entirely new awaits you. They want you to know that. So it's kind of like giving you a heads up. Something new is coming in. Wonderful surprises are coming. You kept on getting divine intervention, like divine things are meeting you at this time. So you'll be having a lot of new, wonderful things coming in to surprise you. Has been a recurring message. So here we get it again. Your messages from your higher self. Wonderful surprises are coming. Some things that are entirely new await you. A are coming in and we're getting, yes, leave your usual social circles behind. If you felt a resonance with this card as it was being shown, I certainly did. Leave your usual social circles behind. Seek out true companions. You've really been probably, especially during this time, I must say, with everything that has been changing and transforming around us, you could find that your usual social circles, some have fallen away. You've gone closer to real true companions, those that are more aligned with your soul at this time. That's just been a recurring message. And if you haven't done that, to do that. So things that are more true to you, more aligned to you right now, like find out those true companions. Seek out even more true companions for yourself that are more aligned with your higher self. And you could find, if you look back a couple of years, that the people that you're resonating more strongly with have changed. And it's a weird time. Sometimes during those times, you could feel almost like alone through the transition. But believe me, like new people, more aligned to who you are resonating at with now, like where your higher self is. You do find companions. You are not alone, and you do find people. And so, yeah, leave your social, your usual social circles behind. Seek out true companions. So that is going to be lit up in your life going forward, to seek those that are more true companions. And I'm just saying, you can look back and see, you know, the people that have left and the people who have come in. Yeah, the time is right. Yes, seize the day and make progress on your soul path. Yes, seize the day. This was that whole message about today. Today is why I'm here. They even maybe post, it was a special spirit message ship. Seize the day, quite literally. Make progress on your soul path. The time is right. You know, there are new things coming in here. Definitely you're going to be finding truer companions along the way. The time is right to go forward and make progress on your soul path. I want to keep going for some reason. Usually I stop, but wonderful new things are coming in. So seize the day, like seize every day. That also is number, they're drawing my attention to the number is 11. It's almost like rise up and be aligned in the day. Rise up with all you are made of and align with your higher self as you greet the day. Seize the day, make progress on your soul path, align to your higher self. I just want to say that. They were saying that, like, stay aligned for all your actions and reactions as you go forward and make progress on your soul path going forward. We've been assisted. Okay, they're going to make me change this. Yes, you cannot make this up. The whole point, rise above the dark days of your life. And that's what we're being encouraged to do. Do not fight them, but have faith that the light will always return. And not only that, rise above the dark days. Look how she almost looks like a warrior, rising above challenges and circumstances. Do not fight them. I had a separate spirit message tip that I posted on the channel about you don't fight the darkness, you bring in more light. So you bring in more strength, you bring in more light, you bring that in for yourself and bring that to situations. You rise above, you're bigger than any problem. You can rise above challenges, problems, obstacles, bring in more light. Don't fight them. Have faith that the light will always return. You hold fast to this vision of light. You know, everything is going to be working out. Stay positive. You bring in more light. We are rising above the challenges, the dark days. So definitely you're probably going to be supported by people who really are, that you're resonating more fully with. It's definitely the time is right to go forward, more aligned to your higher self. Rise above the dark days of your life. The new, wonderful new things are coming in. They want me to get one more. Wonderful new things are coming in. So hold on to that vision. You know, hold on to a bright view of the future. Rise above the dark days of your life. That's what we're all being compelled to do. So that's probably why you need these social circles of light, you know, more higher vibration to help support you to hold this vision and be that way and walk this way in your life at this time. Yes, because new strategies are required. New strategy is required. Find the path to love and happiness. This is all supporting a new path to love and happiness as we go forward. Yeah. It's supporting new strategies, new ways of doing things. Rise above the dark days with new strategies. Find the path to love, more love and happiness. The time is right. So seize the day and keep going. They're probably going to be assisting you or helping you with new ways of doing that, new strategies. What to do has been a recurring message to rise above the challenges, what's going on in your life. I want to get one more. Yeah, one more. Okay, and we're getting, yep, release your inner rebel. Be yourself and create your own universe. And that's what they're employing you to do. So rise up in your full self, apply all your skills, your talents, align with your higher self for all your actions, reactions, seize the day, greet the day. We're rising above the dark days, holding a bright vision of the future, and you're creating new strategies. You're probably being supported by new social circles, like new truer companions that help you to release, quite literally, be in your fire, your light, release your inner rebel, be yourself, and literally create your own universe. And that is what we're being supported to do at this time, to rise above the darkness and to start creating, going forward, creating your own universe all every day, every step of the way. And they're assisting you as well. We're all rising above the dark days, right? So release your inner rebel, be yourself, and create your own universe right now. You have the support of better companions to support you with that. You're aligned to your higher self. The time is right. Literally seize the day and make progress. They're helping you with new strategies to rise above the dark days. Do not fight. Bring in more light. It's like release your inner rebel. Release your light to be yourself and create your universe. That's what's being supported. Wonderful new things are coming in for you. So I want to leave it with that. So this has been the Self-Helper Oracle. There were 43 cards in here. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. You can also go into the guidebook, like release your inner rebel. Let's read this one. I didn't read each and every card, so let me give you a taste of creating this one for us, okay? So release your inner rebel, be yourself, and create your own universe. The heart of a rebel beats within us all. Yes, we understand. Let's put it here, you can read with me. The heart of a rebel beats within us all. We understand Lilith and her urge for self-determination and freedom because we have already felt this impulse. And at this moment, you'll feel it strongly too. If you're not familiar with the story of Lilith, here's a brief outline. God originally created Adam and gave him a wife as a companion, according to the Talmud. This first wife was called Lilith, and she was of equal birth, self-confident, proud, and a free woman. She refused to serve Adam and wanted to be in a dominant position. When they made love, which displeased Adam, he wanted to dominate, and an argument ensued. Lilith spoke the secret name of the Lord, which resonates full of magic, and parted from Adam, leaving him as a free and self-determined woman. Wow. It is said that she had made children but lost them as punishment for her disobedience and individualism. Lilith wanted to be free. Oh my God, this free spirit. She was not meant for a small world. You have drawn this card because you too need more space and freedom for yourself. Emerge from your constraining cocoon. You are a child of Lilith. All witches, shamans, and healers, all wise men and women, all those to whom knowledge is given have a spiritual connection to Lilith, who wants to oppress you, who wants to oppress you, who wants to take your place, who is crossing boundaries. Rebuke them, but clearly and with love, since people are sometimes unaware of their incorrect behavior. Follow the path of your soul, the path of freedom, and pay no attention to the complaints and criticisms of others. They do not know that you can create your own universe. How beautiful. So the power animal is condor. And the herbal essence oil is jasmine. The healing crystal is emerald. And the number 5. I really love this. Follow the path of your soul, the path of freedom, and pay no attention to complaints and criticisms of others. Create your world. There's been a lot about that. It's like follow your higher self and your guidance and what you're connected to, and not so much, the criticism, likes, and feedback of others. Stay aligned to yourself and create your world. Absolutely. So wonderful new things are coming in here. We're rising above the dark days. Absolutely. Probably have much higher vibration, soul, social circles, or companions to support you better. And the time is right. Definitely to seize the day and make progress on your soul path. And you're supported to be in your light creating at this time. Wonderful new things coming in here, bringing more positivity and love and light into your world. So this has been the Soul Helper Oracle close-up review and bonus reading. And I love those cards. I love even just the title, Soul Helper Oracle. Beautiful new deck from Christina Arana Faber, and illustrated again. It was illustrated by Elena Judra. Beautiful. Really, really beautiful. And I could see it's like good for all ages too. It really is. Okay. I wish you the best. Take care. Bye-bye.